You have a home. It protects you from the cold and rain. It provides you with shelter from the environment. You probably have cupboards with food and water that comes out of the tap. Your home is your habitat. Humans are special because instead of adapting to our surroundings, we create dwellings that enable us to survive in a variety of environments. We're innovative. We use tools, create shelters, and make things that allow us to survive in many different habitats. Other living things need specific habitats to survive and thrive. Different animals live in different habitats based on their needs, what they look like, and their behaviors. A habitat will provide a living organism with what it needs to survive, such as food, water, air, space, shelter, and light. If you look around our science center, you'll see we have many kinds of animals. Each one has evolved into an animal that is suited to its environment or habitat. Each one looks quite different from the other. These frogs wouldn't be found in a desert habitat. They're found by permanent bodies of water and hibernate underwater. Spotted salamanders prefer deciduous or mixed forests and hillsides around ponds. They're often found in burrows or under logs. Amphibians have moist, scaleless skin and are rarely found in drier habitats. Our beaver is also an aquatic animal, but it's evolved differently from amphibians and therefore looks and behaves differently. We say living organisms are adapted to their habitats, but this needs to be explained further. The features and behaviors of living things enable them to survive and be more successful in a given habitat. Beavers with webbed feet and broad tails survived better than beavers without these features. Webbed feet made for better swimmers that required less energy. These animals had to eat less and were more successful. Beavers with large enough tails could balance better on land while carrying long pieces of wood. These beavers probably built higher quality lodges and were more likely to survive winter. They had more offspring and passed these traits on to the next generation. Over time, all beavers had these features. Beavers became a species. They became adapted to their habitat. Let's look at our other large rodent. Porcupines have long claws for climbing up trees and sharp quills that protect them from most predators. Animals without long claws could not climb trees as well. Animals that didn't have quills had less protection and were eaten more often. They did not pass on their traits. Porcupines and beavers are both large rodents, but they look different from one another and behave differently based on where they found themselves in the environment. Their habitat influenced their evolution. Beavers protect themselves from predators by building lodges. Porcupines are safe from most predators because of their quills. But there's one animal that is considered an expert at hunting porcupines. Fishers are predators in the weasel family. They specialize in hunting porcupines for food. Fishers attack the porcupine's face, which doesn't have quills. Even if the porcupine corners itself against a tree, fishers are able to climb the tree and attack from above. Needless to say, we don't have any fishers in our science center. So this porcupine is able to wander around worry-free. These animals are part of a food chain, or food web, that exists in a forested habitat. Porcupines are herbivores, feeding off of plants. Fishers are carnivores. They eat porcupines, but their diet might include smaller rodents like chipmunks, squirrels, and snowshoe hare. The fisher has few predators other than humans, but sometimes it's threatened by bobcats and lynx because they all compete for the same food. We like to think that everything is where it needs to be, but if a habitat is undergoing some sort of change, the resident animals and plants might not be suited to what the habitat is becoming. A rapid change in habitat can lead to loss of living organisms, and sometimes, extinction of species. We need to be conscious of how we treat the environment, and realize that human actions have an impact on plant and animal habitats. Animal habitats are, in a sense, their homes. In order to help these animals and protect them, we need to respect and protect their home habitats.